So I thank the organizers for this invitation and welcome, because it's the first lecture. I will speak about an old result with Bertrand Thoen and a new result, which is a work in progress with Mathieu Hanel. And it is about relative algebraic geometry. And the idea is to do geometry, to have new spaces. And this is one way, and we call it algebraic because it's a very algebraic way to do geometry. And the first part, we consider C, no, in all this talk, in fact, C will be a symmetric monoidal category. We assume that, in fact, we have an internal home. And in fact, we assume that C is complete and co-complete. And in fact,
Can you write internal homes? Because as well, it's still... Can you write internal homes? That's not
important. Oh.
Yeah. it's easy to forget. Yeah.
Oh.
So you have an the last symbol is the identity?
No, it's a unity. I call it one. Yes, yes. And later we will assume that C is locally presentable, in fact. But in the beginning, we don't need this hypothesis.
Do you suppose additivity?
No.
So coproduct, finite coproduct, and finite product do not coincide in general.
No.
Okay.
Sets.
Yeah.
Sets. The first example is a set. This is the idea. So we define what I call mon C or mon if there is no ambiguity, which is a category of commutative monoid. In C, I recall this is M in C with a map from M tensor M to M and epsilon from 1 to M with the usual property, associativity, commutativity, unit, and so on. And with this, we know that we can define if M is a commutative monoid in C, we can define the category of M modules. So it's the same way. This is an object in C with a map from M tensor X to X with all what you want. And this new category, in fact, is there is a new tensor product on M mod, and the category M mod with this new product and M is a symmetric monoidal category. Yes, close also. And what we need, maybe the category of monoid in M mod is what we call the M algebra, and in fact, it is equivalent to the category of monoid under M. Okay. This is just to have a notation. Now we have the forget functor from C, from M mod to C. This functor has a left adjoint. Which we denote by this. And which is equivalent to this in that same way. And just the last thing, elementary thing I need is if I take U, which is a map from M to N in Mon. I don't explain what is a map in the category of monoid. We can define an adjunction, which is from M module to N module. This is a forget functor. We can see any N module as a M module. And this one is equivalent to the tensor product by N over N.
In fact, we have three functors because you have an adjoint.
Yes, we have an adjoint because U is conservative and it commutes with all limits and collimits. And so he has also an adjoint, a right adjoint, but we don't need it, so I don't speak about this adjoint.
Is it not just humming? I'm confused, maybe? Humming from hum?
As the adjoint, yes. Yes, but I don't need it, so...
So you don't need to use this... the fact that you lower star commutes with...
No, but it's a fact. I just say it. Okay. It is an answer to the question of, but I don't need that. Maybe I will need that he is conservative, but there are many, many other properties. I speak only of the property I need. Okay. And now we will define what I will call, so this is a definition. What are the category of affine object? This is opposite category of the monoid. So if you want to have an idea of what we are going to do, so this is an example. You take for C the category of abelian groups or Z modules. In that case, Mon is a category of rings, of commutative rings, and F is a category of affine scheme. Yes. It's a category of affine schemes. And so what we want to generalize this example. So the first thing we want to have is a Grothendieck topology on the category F. And I will give you a way to define a Grothendieck topology. So it's a very general result. We take T. T is a category with finite limit. And we take F from T op to cat, which is a pseudo functor. That means that you don't have T, it's only with a natural transformation. You don't have an isomorphism, but a natural transformation. It's some lax functor. And the hypothesis on F is the following. For any x in T, the category Fx is complete and co-complete. Maybe we don't need so many hypotheses, but we take this one. For any morphism P from X prime to X in T, we have P upper star by the functor from F X to F X prime. And so the hypothesis is that P upper star has a right adjoint, which is conservative. And the last hypothesis is the following. For any Cartesian square in T, so we have a natural transformation, we have a morphism from P upper star, Q lower star, to Q prime, lower star, P prime, upper star. And the hypothesis that is an isomorphism. P upper star, no, I don't assume that. I don't need. And in general, it's not true. So so now, what is the object to? And now with this data, we can define a Grothendieck topology on T by the following. So let Pi from Xi to X a family in T. I will say that first, this family is F covering if, so this family is over a set Y, if there exists a subset J, which is finite, such that the family of functors Pi upper star from Fx to Fxi is conservative. That means that a map in Fx is an isomorphism if the image, all the image of Pi upper star of this map are isomorphism. Okay, we say that the family is flat if for any I, Pi upper star is left exact. And we say that the family is faithful flat. So if 1 and 2. It is a covering, which is flat family, which is a covering. And now the result is that this family define a pretopology. So maybe the first result. The faithful flat families define a pretopology on T.
And the covering ones don't define a pretopology?
Sorry?
The condition one. Does it define a pretopology?
I don't know. But I will need this second condition to have the fact that this topology is subcanonical. And in fact, I have a stronger result in some sense, theorem. In fact, the pseudo-functor F is a stack for this topology. And one way to say that, it is, in fact, this is exactly the flat descent. And for any x in T, for any family UI over x, we can define the category of the descent data from U over x. For F. So the object of this category are the family xi phi I dry such that xi is an object in the category F of ui and phi I dry is an isomorphism between the restriction to xi. This has a meaning with x jai restricted to ui u jai. Ui u jai is the cross product of ui by u jai over x. So this is the object with the co-cycle condition. You have also what are the morphism. And in fact, to say that f is a stack is to say that we have the descent, that means the following. F is a stack, is equivalent to say the following. For any x in T, for any faithfully flat family or covering we have a natural we have a natural functor from fx to the category of the descent data of u over x for f, and we want that for any x and any covering family, this is an equivalence of category. And in some sense, the proof of this theorem is the same as the proof in the classical setting of rings. Okay.
Can you use a Beck Magnetic State theorem in the source?
I don't know if we use it. Maybe we do that at the end, but maybe it's a consequence, but I don't know. Okay, so now we will apply this construction.
Excuse me, can you give a hint on how you make the gluing for the data? What? How do you define the gluing? Comment se fait le recollement?
How do you push? If you have descent data, how do you get the object that you want to
I don't remember what
this is like in Grothendieck space.
I don't remember exactly. I think that it is because this is we do the same that the for rings, but I don't remember. I don't want to say something. I am afraid I cannot give you the answer now.
You're not supposing that the P or star have a left hand one, P or three?
Yes.
Yes, but.
Because that would maybe help
I think that we have to do this. I don't remember, but we consider the sum of UI. You need that the category is complete and co-complete, and you have to construct something by the end. But I don't remember now. I cannot give you. Okay. So now we want to apply this to the category of affine object or affine schemes in C, and we will use the same terminology. So we say that a map. So we take U from A to B, which is a map in Mon. In the monoid, the commutative monoid in C, we say that U is flat if U upper star from A mod to B mod is left exact. So U is epimorphism, so this is classical definition of epimorphism. 3U is of finite presentation. That means that for any diagram, filtering diagram, so maybe I will write it, which is a filtering diagram on Amon. We have a natural morphism from the collimit. So the collimit of AI to B to the OM, and we have BAI, sorry, and B. Colin A high. And we want that this map is an ISO.
Epimorphism is epimorphism in the category mon C or epimorphism in C? What do you mean by epimorphism? In the category mon C or
where?
Number two.
All the morphism in mon C. Yeah, yes. Oh. Alors, je sais pas si. And the last definition is we say that U is a Zariski open immersion if 1, 2, and 3. And now, if I consider a map in the category, so in the opposite category, so I will call A, B, in half. By convention, if I have A, which is an object in Mon, I will denote by AA the object in the category half. This is a convention. So if I have a map which corresponds to U, I say in the same way that F is flat if U is flat. F is mono if U is epi. F is of finite presentation if U is of finite presentation. So in that case, it's not the usual definition of finite presentation in the category F.
I suppose you have B A and not A B exponent A not A exponent B, which doesn't.
It's kind of like spec, yeah.
Yes, this is, because I don't want to use spec, so I use A B and A. This is a notation. I don't want to use spec because I will use spec later. A B. Like the affine space associated to B. And for F is Zariski open immersion if U is the same. And in the case of commutative rings, we recover the definition, not the definition, but the property of Zariski open immersion. That in fact, the Zariski open immersion in the category of affine schemes, the usual affine schemes, are exactly the flat monomorphism of finite presentation. So, I say that a family now, UI, so this is a to V is our, so a faithful flat and quasi compact covering. If for any I, Fi is flat, and there exists a finite subfamily, so finite, such that the family of functor Ui upper star from A mod to Bi mod is conservative. So this is the first definition. And the second definition, a family, so the same, is a Zariski covering if for any I, Fi is a Zariski open immersion, and the second one is the same. So by the general result I give you before, this two definition define topology, and so we have defined on the category half the faithful flat quasi-compact and the Zariski topology. And we know that the faithful flat quasi-compact topology is subcanonical, so Zariski, the Zariski one also. So we have the sheaf for this cut for the FFQC topology, which is included in the sheaves for the Zariski topology, in the pre-sheave.
But the category is not small. It is known that this gives difficulties in this case. That is,
they are not small, but you can define a topology in the, if you want. But
to define a category of sheaves.
So in, if you want, in, I will do just now, I will take PF, but wait 1 minute, and we have this there by Yoneda. And now I will use the hypothesis of a locally presentable on C, and in fact I will use the following hypothesis, because I will need it later. Here I don't need this hypothesis, but I will need later, that in fact mon is a generated by the monomorphism of finite presentation. And in fact, we can see that the end of this category. If I define IAF PF as the opposite category of the category of monoid of finite presentation, I have in the same way AF, which is the pro-object in AF PF. And this one are small categories. I will need it later. For the moment, in fact, I don't need that. Okay. And But if you want, we will. You can take just now this hypothesis. So we will forget this topology because, in fact, for what we do, we don't need this topology. We will use only the Zariski topology. And we say we want to define this new geometric object by the functor of points. And so we want to say that these objects are, in fact, shifts in topology. We are locally a fine object. So for this, we have to define what are the open immersion in a more general for shifts. So first, we take X, which is an affine object. We take F, which is a shift. So when I say shifts now, it's always for the Zariski topology. And F, which is a subobject of X in the category of shifts. By Yoneda, and I will see the category F as a subcategory of the category of shifts. I don't say H of X or something like that. So I say that F X is a Zariski open immersion if there exists UI X, which is a family in F, with for any I the map, I don't know, GI is a Zariski open immersion, which is defined because we have a fine schemes. And if I consider the map G from the coproduct of U of Y high in X, so this is in the shifts. The image of G is F. So I have defined what are a general open immersion for an affine scheme. And now I take FG, which is a map of shifts, G. I say that G is Zariski open immersion if for any X in G with X an affine scheme, the cross product F cross X over G on X is a Zariski open immersion. Okay. And now I can define what is a scheme. I take F, which is a shift for the Zariski topology in F. And I say that F is a scheme. So it's a relative scheme over C. If there exists a family UI of affine scheme and map PI from UI to F, such that first for any I, PI to F is a Zariski open immersion, and two, if I take P, which is the sum of PI, this is an EP. That means exactly that F is obtained by gluing a fine subscheme. So you see that in the usual case, we define the Zariski topology by the closed subset. We have ideal and closed subset. And in that case, we define Zariski topology by open subset. But in fact, this is the reason why we do that is because we don't have additivity. We cannot define what's an ideal, and and the lack of additivity implies that we don't have the notion of ideal. So maybe I will not have time to speak about change of context. So just to say maybe some example. So the first example is the one I gave you before. Is C is Z module. What we obtain is the usual skins. So this is the geometry over Z, or spec Z. But we can take C, which is, for instance, set with the product, and the unit is the set with one element. And in that case, we take geometry. So over, this is one definition of F1. There is another one, 2 prime, if we take set, pointed set. This is the one that Alain prefers. Yes, with smash, in that case, because smash. So this is the one Alain used. So this is also in other definition of F1.
In fact, the better definition is with gamma sets. There is another,
maybe, one way, but I am not a specialist, but one way to think about tropical geometry, but it is a... is to consider for the category C, the category of monoid, or n modules. In this category, you consider an algebra I will call B. So this is the algebra with 2 objects, with 0 plus.
C'est le S de Joliard, c'est la même chose. Ça, la topologie, c'est le S que Joliard.
Ah, d'accord.
C'est ça, la topologie.
So and you have 1 plus 1 is. With this is this one. OK. And you can define the relative geometry over B. You consider the category of B module. You take for C the category of B modules. And you can define a geometry which is related with tropical. But I don't know exactly. I will need to speak with people who make tropical geometry to know what is exactly the relation between these two things. And the idea is that what we have some change of context, and there is some you can do. You can say that a scheme is defined over Z can be. You can see this scheme as a scheme defined over, for instance, N, and so on. But I don't have time to speak about that. I will prefer to speak about the more recent result, which is the spectral functor. So the idea is the following. You take F, which is a sheaf, and we consider the poset of the Zariski open immersion over F. So this is, in fact, so this is a poset, and in fact, it is a frame. I think that you have seen what is a frame. So this is a distributive lattice, complete distributive lattice. And there is a, so you have the category of frame. The opposite category of frame is the category of local. And so we can consider this in this category. So we consider this as an object in the category of local. And we know that there is an adjunction. So this is the right adjoint point and the left adjoint open subset from the category of topological space. And now we consider the image of this local by the functor of point. So this is a topological space. And this is what I will call the spec, the spectrum. So we have defined a functor spec from the category of sheaves to the category of, in fact, the sober topological spaces, because we know that the image by this functor are the sober spaces. That's an F to the category of point of the local there over F. And this functor commutes with colimits, and he sends Zariski open immersion to open immersion of topological space. So what we have done, we have associated to a sheaf a topological space. And this is the idea of what is the first, maybe, definition of a scheme. The first definition of a scheme is a topological space with some structure over it. And with Mathieu, we have tried to do the same in this context. And so we want now to define what is the analog of locally ringed space. So we want to define what we play the role of this sheaf in a local ring.
So you which topology on affine you use here? Any topology?
What topology?
Which sheaf on F?
Zariski. I say at the beginning that I will use only this topology.
No, I was alluding before to some topological example, like you can take fields of higher and higher transcendence degree and take this joint union of the spec. Then for any ring, there are only those with cardinality less than the can map to the ring anyway. You get something which is too large, and then you go. So you don't define a set, so this will not. So if you do as you did with possibly large category.
Oh yes, oh, I forgot that I need to use half. Yes, in this part now I will use. Okay. Yes, yes. This is the reason why I make this hypothesis before. Okay.
Sorry. Why you need a sheet?
Why I need? Say if I take a pre-sheaf, yes, I can define. I am not sure that I have the commute with colimit. Yes, well, for the moment, I think that I don't need the sheaf. For the moment, yes, but I will use it later for sheaves. Yes, but I don't need it. So maybe. Okay. Just I will recall something about, so it is a reminder about topos. Just if I take E, for me a topos, it's always a Grothendieck topos. So the category of geometric morphism from the topos of set, sorry, to E, which is called the category of point of E. And this is the same as the pair of adjoint functor from E to the category of set with U, which is left exact. So you have already seen that. And that if the category of pre-sheaves on a small category C, then in fact the point of E is the same as the category of left exact functor. A C is small category with finite limit. From C to set. And in fact, this is the same as the category pro C.
There is a duality between pro C and the category of left exact functor. I think you should use the opposite of the category of left exact functor if you want to. It's just a small point, but we are always getting very confused with this.
Yes. You mean for morphism of points, they go back.
What is the morphism between two points?
Ah, yes.
This is explained very carefully.
But this is the reason why some people call model and not geometric.
Yeah, you want to use Grothendieck convention, I guess.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So then it's pro C, but it's not the, it's the opposite of the category of left exact functor.
Yes.
That's.
Oui, oui, yes. So, for me, it's not. Just to say that in that case, in the case where E is the category of sheaves for some topology, and the topology tau is defined by a pretopology, is defined by covering family, we have the point of E in that case is a functor which send. I don't write it, which send a covering family to epimorphic family. And what it is important, it's what I get there is what I will call log C, and I will give you what we obtain. I'm sorry because it's time, so. So I say that an object X in pro C is local if for any y in C, for any covering family and for any map from X to I, there exists a factorization by some object in the covering family. This is what I call the local object. Ah, d'accord.
Il vous reste 11 minutes, questions comprises.
Bon. Bon, ça dépend si vous voulez poser des questions ou pas. D'accord, bon, ça va, j'avais peur, mais il est 11h. Bon, mais je... Alors. And always, if you think in the category of commutative rings, what we obtain is exactly the local rings and with the Zariski topology, but it's not important for the moment. And, okay. So I will define now the Hellmon, which is the topos of sheaves for the Zariski topology, which is a subtopos of Mon, which is a category of pre-sheaves. And we see that the point of this topos are so the what I call the local object of half, which is a subcategory of the point of the category of pre-sheaves, which is a pro-object of half PF, and by assumption, this is exactly half. Okay, and now we have the proposition, and this proposition is what corresponds to the sheaf of locally ringed spaces. For any x in the category of sheaves, there exists a geometric morphism. So I call OX, you recognize it, from the category of sheaves over spec X to Hellmon. And I give you some explanation maybe there. In the case of a commutative ring, this Hellmon is in fact the Zariski topos. And this is the spec X is the topological space as I have defined before, which is associated to my scheme. So I have a topological space. And I have this map, and this is exactly what we do when we consider the OX in the usual scheme. It is exactly this. Because what's mean to define this geometric morphism? In fact, to define OX is equivalent, in fact, to the following. So first, is equivalent to have a map from the affine schemes of finite presentation to the category of sheaves. So I recall that, in fact, this is the same as the category of sheaves of the Zariski over X. So which is a left exact and sand, so covering families to epimorphic families. Hop. And this is the same that to have a functor from half PF cross zar X hop to half. A set, the category of set, and which send AN U to the set of homomorphism of sheaves from U to AN. So I had enough time to convince you that this is exactly what is the sheaf OX in the usual context of schemes, but it is exactly the same. So I will not I have not time to say something about factorization system, but you see that when you consider morphism of schemes, of usual schemes, you know that you have the notion of local morphism. You cannot consider all morphism between even local rings, even rings. You have the notion of local morphism, so I don't have time to explain this.
You mean on locally ring space?
Yes, but in fact, this is you have to define it at the level of rings. And we can define the same notion of local ring, of local morphism at the level of local monoids. Then we can extend it to obtain the notion of local morphism between locally ringed or not monoid sheaves. And this is what we need to obtain the last result, maybe. So we will define the category Lmon. So this is a category of topos T with a map OT from T to Lmon. So this is what we call the structured topos. So we have obtained one. And in this category, we have a subcategory which is not full. Subcategory with same object, but with local morphism. So this is what we need. And in that case, so this is the maybe the more difficult part is this one. And then, so this category, we call this category Lmon topos, we call lock. And if I restrict now, I can restrict, in fact, to locally topos. So I can define L om sober, because the locally topos is, I can see that as a topos on a space. And in the same way, Lmon sober lock. And the theorem maybe is the following. So we have a morphism. From the category of sheaves to this category. This morphism is a morphism which sent F to spec F with OF. Spec F is my sober space. And OF is the geometric morphism from spec F to Lmon, what I have defined before. So there exists a morphism, which is a co-continuous, which is a sans risk open immersion, in open immersion, etc. But what it is important, it induces an equivalence of category between the category of schemes I have defined before and the category of geometric schemes, and I will define what is a geometric schemes. A geometric schemes is an object in this category which is locally for the usual topology, we have this is a topological space, which is locally a fine scheme. So this is locally and a fine skin. And we recover exactly the equivalence we have between the two definitions of schemes for over commutative rings. This definition is a definition of you have in EGA, topological space, which is locally with a locally ringed space, which is locally affine. And this the definition of scheme I gave at the beginning, which is the definition of scheme as functor of points. Okay, let me stop there.
I just have two small remarks. I mean, the first one is that it seems that this general framework has a potential where you can enhance the result by, for instance, if I want to do a homotopy theory, I can use the simplicial category, and I can take the simplicial objects in the category you started with. I suppose it's still a monoidal closed category if I do that, and then I can apply the machine to this.
I don't understand.
What I mean is that if I take simplicial objects
yes.
in the category you start with C,
yeah.
I still get.
Yes.
So then I can apply the machine to this, and the idea would be that by using the analog of the Dolkan correspondence, you get a kind of homotopy theory for the.
Yes, no, yes, and if you want to do that, in fact, there is someone who has done that. You have to stabilize, and in fact, you have to use something which is like a spectrum, and you recover something. Yes, you can do that. Yes, and you can define a homotopy theory. Yes.
And my second point is that somehow, you know, at some point, you have given up the general, very big generality by using locals. So I mean, you have, because many of the notions that you introduced, they could be applied to more general topos, not
yes.
just local.
Yes.
So somehow you have gone back to the classical topological yes. spaces.
But for instance, if we want to have not Zariski topology, but Etal topology, and I think this is a way to define Etal topology in that case. You need topos and not local, yes.
And one final remark, which is that, you know, Scholz has a beautiful definition of the pi 1, where he doesn't choose any finiteness condition. And I think you have the ideal setup to apply his definition in general, because you have flatness, you have the product and everything. So probably, literally, his definition would make sense in your paper.
Okay, thank you, I will.
Questions? Okay, you can have a